Sarah, why is Mirvac involved in the Freemasons' suicide prevention campaign?
Good partnerships really start with sharing common interests, and Mirvac is really proud to work with Freemasons Victoria on this important issue. Our purpose is to reimagine urban life, and we're doing that in a variety of ways. Of course, it's part of our core business to create communities, and as part of that work, we're really looking to support people with being physically healthy, so active, healthy bodies in terms of the green spaces that we create, as well as healthy social connections and doing things as simple as knowing your neighbour. And those sorts of health initiatives are really part of who we are and what we do and what we value. And it's relevant for this program because this is about starting conversations. This is about making those meaningful connections. And that's what we're both all about.
Now, will you be getting your staff involved in this?
Our staff are involved, yes. We've got a range of health and wellbeing programs already at Mirvac. There are a number of them, actually. Flexibility really is at the heart of what we do. Every employee is empowered to work in a way that suits them. And of course, that's good for people's physical health and it's good for their mental health too. Having that balance around being able to be fully present, not just as an employee, but as a human. And one of the ways that we do that is through a little program called My Simple Thing, which encourages all employees to have a conversation with their manager about one simple thing that would help them manage their work-life balance. And of course, that's about managing their mental and physical health as well. And so that could be a range of things, and it's really about having that open dialogue. So for example, my boss comes into work at 10 o'clock on Thursdays because he is taking his son to breakfast that day. So the start of those conversations are really important. They're important because they help us identify the things that help to keep us healthy, but they also generate a conversation and a safe place to start that kind of honest and human exchange between managers and employees. We've also got, as you would know, a construction business, which is quite a masculine business. And
it's a pretty tough environment, the construction business, and everyone is tough on the site. But of course, you take a lot of care with your construction workers.
Yeah, we've got a program which is really fantastic in our construction business. It started there, it's called Mates. And it's about training some of our employees to be able to identify signs of mental ill health and give them the tools that they need to start those conversations, and identifying people we call connectors to put those people in touch with other people to help them start the conversation and hopefully advance towards getting the help that they might need.